Our concern with PM2.5 really revolves around its effect on health. PM2.5 also is a concern because the diameter is very close to what the wavelength of visible light is, so it's very effective at scattering visible light, and that's why it's hard to see through smoke. It scatters the light so well, which reduces visibility.
Particulate matter, specifically PM2.5, is a major component of smoke coming from vegetation fires. PM2.5 includes all matter in the air, which is 2.5 microns in diameter or less. For comparison, 2.5 microns is 30 times less than the diameter of a human hair. Material of this size is of great concern because it is able to find its way past the body's natural filtration systems in the nose and throat and work its way into the lungs. According to the EPA, these health issues are of particular concern to children, older adults, people with heart or lung disease, and people living in poverty.
One has to look at the full suite of air quality impacts from the smoke from our prescribed fire operations. Also in that concern are the precursors to ozone formation, which is another regulated air pollutant. And virtually all of these are a concern when one looks at air quality. The largest amount of material that is emitted, though, that is a regulated air pollutant, is particulate matter. And so many of our strategies have been developed specifically addressing that particular pollutant. The climactic conditions that happen around some of the burns in the southeast can result in very high levels of fog entrained with smoke after prescribed fires. This safety issue is a big concern in the southeast. So we look at that safety issue as well as the safety of our own personnel in those circumstances.
Air quality regulators from adjoining agencies, along with Forest Service air quality specialists, provide direction to those conducting prescribed burns to ensure that air quality standards are maintained for the protection of the public.